श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः। सिट ऑडिबल। According to the inescapable rule and framework of the whole cosmos, there are few unavoidabilities, that is the dilapidation of energy, depletion of resources, disease of body or organisms, and finally death or demise of structures in living forms. So these things are unavoidable. And you know that everybody is having, as per the science of hedonics and eudaimonics, everybody is having a feeling that they must be joyous, uninterruptedly joyous by means of a disease, diversification and factors of even departure in the form of death. Naturally, there are few people who are not having the fear of death or fear of disease. Those people can be classified into two extremities, with absolute realization and with absolute nihilism or absolute ignorance. Those who are atrociously vehement, for them they don't bother about the death, they don't bother about destruction, they don't bother about fame, they don't bother about socialization, etc. And those who are in the abstract end of realization of reality, they too also have the same thing, bothering about nothing. So we have a basic feeling that we are afraid of death, we are afraid of old age, we are afraid of diseases, we are afraid of mental imbalance. All of these things are bothering us very much. But death is an one-time activity, and eschatology is a science that deals with what happens after death, which nobody has repatriated from the abode of after-death experience, and they have not come to us and narrated. But that which is cruel than death, that which is a perennial death. Death is an instantaneous activity, the continuity of which is unintelligible. But the cruel form of death, the incessant shower of the feeling of death, is insecurity. If a person is insecure, he is dying each and every second. And as somebody told, bravery, self-confidence, and rooting into the supportive factors of proper activity or dynamism, that can give you feeling of security. Feeling of security is different from being secure. Feeling of security is different from being secure. And moreover, if the force that has causated this insecurity, there are also three types. One is the peril, which is in the form of a national ubiquity, a global ubiquity, or which has more permeation. In such serious activities or serious circumstances, the feeling of insecurity is natural, as well as biological, as well as by the psychological implications. The feeling of insecurity on areas where they are beyond our control, where they are magnificent in stage, where they are hyper conspicuous in nature, the feeling of insecurity is natural biologically and psychologically. Wherever they are manageable, there will be an initiative or inceptive insecurity. Then persons who can balance, they can balance themselves, and within few minutes they can just reconfigure themselves to look for the solutions for the problem, not totally getting into the problem of lamentation or solitude or self-exploitation. They will not go for such process. So many petty issues are there for insecurity. So many things on basis of observations and expectations. If something has happened, like robbery or looting that has happened in the neighborhood, naturally that will create some feeling of insecurity with the neighbor people. So there are petty issues or trivial issues, there are conspicuous issues, and there are hyper conspicuous issues. And the thing of bravery must not be just bravery of concept. If a person is really brave, that bravery must blossom into dynamic activity, wherein by the person, sparing no effort, undertakes all the possible measures within his might. So bravery is not a concept, bravery is something which is in practical usage. Bravery is a practical, demonstrative, exemplary implementation style, and it, no doubt, it blossoms from concept. That which blossoms from concept and dies within the mind, that is not bravery, that is blind audacity or impudence as per psychology. So what we want is, real security, not feeling that we are secure or imagining that we are secure and thinking that we are secure and opening the doors and unlocking all of our lockers and allowing all persons into it, it is not the proper way. So it is having the same feeling. If somebody feels that they are secure, there are only three possibilities. The person is very responsible and he is very active, number one. Number two, he is amidst an administration which is good governance, which is a masculine rule. Number three, he has surrendered to God. These are all the only three ways which are available by which a person can feel secure. That he is responsible, he is undertaken, he is being entrusted to a responsible governance, he has surrendered to the ultimate reality who is more responsible, more merciful, hyper-potential, all-embracing and omniscient and omnipotent. These are all the three ways for becoming really secure. And regarding the topic, national security, dream or reality, if you say that dream or reality, as per logics, we have discussed about disjunction. Is it dream or reality? Then immediately there is a problem. You are thinking that dream is different from reality. It is not so. Whatever that is there in your dream, dream is of three types. We cannot think that all dreams are just what we see. There are innumerable types of dreams. All dreams that we see, they are not be totally hastily generalized by the fallacy of hasty generalization or hasty commonalization. We must not bring everything. Number one, a person who thinks about what he has not qualified himself, where he has not been a deservable tool for getting that benefit, that type of thinking, overthinking without any implementation is known as autism. That is known as autism in psychology, number one. Number two, the imprints are reflection of a person's experiences at the time of sleeping state, that is a dream, that is read in hypnology. That is autism, this is read in hypnology. A person who is having zeal, who is having untiring effort, who is having a great dynamic approach towards achieving something, the achievement for which he has been planning about things in his mind, potentializing and preparing himself, that dream is known as dynamism. So there is a dynamic dream, there is an artistic dream, and there is a hypnotic dream. And that type of dream which we mentioned here is a dynamic dream. That dream should come in reality. So dream comes in reality if the dream is connected with reality. So terrorism, he is also reality. So anti-terrorism, naturally it should be reality. We are all real. We are real. Truth is real. Peace is real. Harmony is real. If the qualities are real, if the beneficiaries are real, if the intruders are real, why can't be the benefaction or the benefit be real? Naturally it is real. Because as this problem of intrusion, this problem of intrusion, naturally as per the global degradation phenomenon, it is coming down the slope. Coming down the slope, it will be accelerated. Whereas to put it into order for reinstallation, as per the push and pull hypothesis of slope survey and slope up climbing, we have to pull it up, so it is arduous. So reality is arduous, but it is real. So we are talking about the real reality. Number one, what is terrorism? To create an eternal fear inside the minds of people. There are two types of terrorism. The feeling of fear is of two types. Person who has committed a mistake, he will be having the fear for punishment. A person who has created disharmony, he will be having the fear of separation. A person who has made a business mistake or error of handling of wealth and its distribution, in which he has hyper-diversified or mali-diversified his assets, he'll be afraid of his social status, his asset status, as well as repute and conductivity and continuity of his business standard in the society. So the fear that is consequential is not terrorism, that is fear. Somebody asked me, what is the difference between fear and vigilance? Being afraid of something where there is a possibility and also trained to assault on the possibilities of that intrusion, that is vigilance. Being afraid of something where we have to be afraid, and also it ends in action, not in just hallucination or self-consolation, that is vigilance. So being afraid of something to be afraid is vigilance, and being afraid of everything irrationally is known as fear. So we have to make our fear vigilance, we have to make our vigilance into knowledge, we have to make our knowledge into implementation, we have to make our implementation well distributed, we have to make our distribution well integrated. If these things are not happening, then immediately it is a daydream, not even a night dream, this will become a daydream. So it lies in our hands to convert. See, somebody asked me, are you going to convert the dream into reality? Then I told that you are converting the reality into dream by your non-cooperation, by lack of your integrity. Now you have to give this security your real status. Its real status is reality. Then, who are the hindering persons? The terrorism has different types. Security is also of different types. Certainly, there is your research work which is going to take place now. Number one, in chillness, you are wearing a sweater. That is also a security tool. But that is not a security tool for bullet. For bulletproof, there is something different. For fireproof, there is something different. Waterproof, there is something different. So security, the level of security, the object of security, the measure of security, grade of security, that is contextual, personal, temporal. It is based on the dimensions of persons, values, contextual emotions, the person's vulnerability, as well as the velocity of the intrusion vector. The vectors of intrusion, they are having velocity. And the receptacles of that velocity, they are having their vulnerability. Based on the velocity, vulnerability, along with the tri-dimensional evaluation of time, place, and contextual circumstances, we have to evaluate what is security. And also, the various other factors which we have to consider are, there are a lot of people who are giving insecurity within the family. That is domestic insecurity. Like domestic violence, that is there. Then social, that of lot of social insecurity due to linguistic barriers, religious barriers, there are a lot of other various things. No doubt they are not directly going to attack and create a very great calamity, but that will deroot the people in attending to security issues and preparing themselves for attacking or counter-attacking these things. So there are two harms. Directly contributing calamity is also calamitous. That is preventing the people from being prepared for waging a war against calamity. It is diluting the strength. We need three things. One, we need strength. We need attention. We need integrity. The strength is diluted. The integrity is disintegrated. Our attention is diverted towards petty issues. Economical issues, social issues, linguistic issues. Innumerable issues are there. They pave the way that we don't think about what we need really. So there are attention diluters, energy diluters, and integrity diluters. There are hundreds of such things. They are the real reasons. They are the real reasons for insecurity rather than the terrorists. There are smugglers, there are rowdies, there are disruptive persons, there are persons engaged in immoral trafficking, there are extremists, there are separatists, they are fundamentalists. Innumerable persons are there in various areas working for that. And terrorists are the persons interested in doing a very great thing. Terrorists have crossed, they have been petrified. They have been totally petrified, made into wood and stone. They don't have any feelings at all. Unless the directed direction or principle of a genocide, mass annihilation, they don't have any other feeling at all. They don't have any other feeling. They have been specially incubated, injected, instilled, and inculcated for the purpose. They don't have anything at all. They are specially designed, created enzymes and structures. So to tackle them, we must have similar strength and prowess in our side, which is not there. First of all, where is the place and person of attack? There are two things. One is targeted, second is untargeted. Or we can say that is a general target or common target or specific target. If somebody is against you, then targeting on you is personal specific target. You are not my target. Common people, I have to disturb the social harmony. I have to disturb your security. I have to disturb the national integration or the national functionary. So common people totally, I'm going to annihilate the people. That is targeted, common, personal attack. Then place is also like that. If you start a good company, you will start at a place where people will come and purchase for construction. For destruction also, where people will assemble like railway stations, the public parks, public malls, where people they used to conglomerate, from there only they will do that. That is a place. So we know whom they will attack. We know when they will attack also. When they will attack, can you do some astrological predictions or something? No, we can clearly understand by socio-psychological impressions and historical records and possibilistic logical interface studies. We can easily understand that. One, reminder, whenever something has occurred before, on the same day, they could have the same vengeance or vehemence and they can do that. Like the famous December 6th. It is something connected with resemblant attack based on reminder theory. Second thing is counter attack. If somebody connected to them, based on them, part and parcel of them, if they are either captivated, if they are executed, or if they are tried, if they are arrested, if they are annihilated, if they are subjected to any sort of a problem, immediately it will have a counter impact there. there is a common impact. Whenever commonly, not personally to people, whenever commonly something happens somewhere which is disturbing to them, immediately they will do like that. So these are all some areas where they will reflect all of these things. And what is the purpose of these terrorists? Purpose of the terrorists is just to demand. What they demand? They demand a place, they may demand a policy, they may demand some persons. When the aircraft was hijacked, they demanded people. Regarding the Kashmir issue, they are demanding a place. In other places, they are demanding policies for protest. So policy, place or persons are demanded. It is a continuous journey. It is a continuous effort. It is a penance and austerity of terrorists in which continuously they are engaged in that. So to do a thing, immediately we know that if you want to organize a seminar, we need manpower, we need technical resources, and we need finance. And we have to beg lot of people, we have to surrender to lot of people, we have to ask from lot of people, request, beseech, threaten, innumerable things we have to do within the possible means, ethical means. For the terrorists, they are having wonderful resources. Well, how it is possible? Because of two reasons. All the other non-terrorists, all the other normal citizens of the country, they have lot of works. They are all classified, like doctors, auditors, then accountants, then advocates, then engineers, they are all classified. Terrorists, they have no classification at all. They are all terrorists. As we are being put into various faculties, we cannot concentrate on that. We have domestic, physical, emotional, mental, financial, social, cultural, moral, political, spiritual, innumerable dimensions. These people, they have only economical, political, and their personal terrorist ideologies and methodologies. They don't have anything at all. Government, it is having a lot of projects. Like rural development, financial development or economical empowerment of the nation, then development of agriculture, food security and irrigation for the society. They have to deal with women empowerment, child care, health and hygiene of the country, defense mechanism and internal security of the system. It has to deal with the tribal welfare. It has to do with the science and technology. So innumerable issues are there before the government. Terrorists, they don't have any issues at all. As terrorists, they don't have any issues of commitment or responsibility. As they don't have any other job to do, they are fully focused on, they are totally dedicated. That's what I used to say in my seminars. I have attended and organized a lot of seminars on terrorism. Terrorism is nothing but patriotism misplaced. All qualities of us, they are very finely located, are embellished in the terrorists. They are fully concentrated on all these things. How they are getting financial resources? Number one, smuggling. Number two, mischief technology. They are organizing lot of coolie works for various industries or government organizations or international agencies by which they get money. Then there are lot of secret and intelligent clandestine supporters within the same society, those who are giving them funds. They are funded by international agencies, either religious agency, political agencies, or international intelligence idiotic agencies. They are not known as intelligent agencies, they are idiotic agencies. They are funding a lot of people to debilitate the standards of nation by which they can get inside and rule to have domination. There are two things. I want to dominate everybody. I want to exploit everybody. If they are having something, I want to exploit. After getting something, I want to dominate. These are all the two wishes of human psychology, which is reflecting in this thing also. Then how they are getting manpower? You see, that's what I told you in one seminar. If I want to make you a patriot, even if I teach you for 5 years, you will rub your ears and you will go to your home and continue what you have been doing. But terrorists, for transformation, within a week he can bring the transformation. A patriot, because for the patriot or the so-called reformers of the society, it comes from their lips, whereas from terrorists, it comes from their brain and mind. It is a synchronized integral dictation system by which they are making the dictatorship very vehemently, very processively and very systematically. That thing is not with the patriotism. Because the methodology of implementation of or installation of the doctrines of terrorism, they are well organized. And this thing is not well organized. So what they are doing? Vehemence injection. By means of three things, three Ds. One is a drug. There are also a lot of chemicals which makes you to have a stubborn and staunch feeling and to make yourself very rigid and non-flexible to any grounds, no possibility of conversion, change, dilution or hyperspecification. That much of drugs are injected, then demo is being done. A very great oral command, what is my oratory and what is my elocution? Their elocution is very wonderful. If Osama bin Laden speaks here, immediately if I speak and if I just go out, everybody will go for lunch. If Osama bin Laden speaks here, everybody will go for lunch, but with Osama bin Laden at Afghanistan or Pakistan. That is the greatness of their oratory, that is greatness of their commitment. Such much they have been made poisonous. by which they can infect others also with that poisonous nature. Whereas whatever we are having piety, we are not having fullest piety, and we don't have tools for installation or transmission of the same piety inside us. That is a very great problem without which we cannot solve these things. So this installation process is very great. And the third thing is technical resources. Accessibility, affordability, storage, transportation, that is what we discussed today. Affordability, how we can do that? Already I told that technology is supplied by great people. How we can create, even we are unaffordable to get the mechanisms, just as he has mentioned, Satyanarayana. Such things, spending crores of rupees, we are reluctant to manipulate and to establish those systems here. But all the other power systems, all the other fruits of science and technology and advancements are easily affordable and accessible to non-state reactors and superpower blocks of the world. We cannot approach and get that. But terrorists can easily get the most greatest advancement. If somebody can get a supply from terrorists to our military, we can get latest weapons which are not available with even the well-developed countries. That is the real greatness. Second thing is accessibility. How we can break the accessibility? He has the cyberspace war. The cyberspace struggle wherein by accessibility, transmission, mutual communication, infiltration, coding, crypting, decrypting, divulging, encipherization, all of these things are possible because of a common aspect. Is there any stone which can be used only for washing your clothes and which will not wound if it is thrown on your head? Is there any such stone available? Naturally, these things are ambivalent, and constructive and destructive usages are common for both ends. Likewise, accessibility is made possible only by information security and also by making those things well projected by filtering systems and revealing systems. How we can do the coding systems are there. If, for example, there is a message, supply 10 apples to Mrs. Shanta. Supply 10 apples to Mrs. Shanta. And what is that to filter and what is that to decode? If it really means that install 10 big bombs at Santa Cruz airport, that is a real message which has been coded and crypted, and just very casually it has given, I have brought that apples from Kashmir, just give that basket of 10 apples to Mrs. Shanta. If it means like that, who can decode it? So there is a basic problem of curbing the terrorism, decoding, crypting. See, there are two things. One is counteraction, second is action. They are all simultaneously emerging. See, you are not only doing research, you are not only having the tools, they are also having the tools, they are also updating and upgrading the tools. That we must take into consideration. The other thing is assembly, fusion and conglomeration. There are lot of explosives, lot of weapons of mass destruction and weapons of annihilation, which are not weapons at all, which are not destructive at all, if they are not assembled, if they are not conglomerated, if they are not fused. If they are similar circuits, which are used for common usage, and if they are connected and fused at a common place for an annihilator, who can prevent it? That is the fallacy or the problem of fusion. Second is problem of assembly. In the same thing, if different parts are disintegrated and they are just kept in different areas, then if you are reassembling it and using it as a weapon, who can prevent it? Conglomeration, various compounds, chemical compounds, unless they are conglomerated. So fusion of power circuits, conglomeration of chemical compounds, and assembly of various parts of destruction weapon tools, they can be easily administered by these people. Who can prevent that? And second is about if there is any aerial view, aerial transport, then if there is any cyberspace where these things are there, there is decoding, encoding, security, then blocking, then deactivation, everything is possible. If aerial things are there, then there is radar, then there is a transmitter, then there is a satellite surveillance, and there is also an internal monitor surveillance, there is an ambuscade surveillance, innumerable things we can make. And for naval things, they have learned a good Bombay lesson. Now they are now going to intensify the naval security, that they can do. Transportation in important areas, where there are powerful areas like metropolitan cities, and where there are, see, they consider both of the people. Even the government that consider the value of the metropolitan citizens or inhabitants to be valuable. And the terrorists also, they are not attacking the rural people or tribal people. Wherever there is money and wherever there is sophistication, wherever there is some sort of luxury, there only both of the people are doing. That way, rural people and tribal people, they are very blessed and benefited, we have to say. So everything we can monitor. But there are lot of places and borders where illicit transportation is being done. I have mentioned those things in the previous lecture on national security, like Bakshar border. There is a Bakshar border of Bihar, and there is a Gorakhpur border for Nepal. near Bhairav, there is a border, innumerable borders from Bhutan, from Sri Lanka border, you can just 20 rupees, you can come in a boat. Immediately, you can come in a boat. So there are a lot of other places. So transportation from other places, number one. Local assembly or local manufacturing of all of these things, number two. Number three, transportation through forest sources and rural sources is easily possible. And you cannot be daily checking on all motions and all notions. It is very impossible. So unless you develop a vigilant system in the toll society, unless you curb all the areas, and you see, if you block, if you catch hold of a person's hand, he cannot just relieve it. If you catch hold of a person's leg, he will be made immobile. But if you close his nostrils, he will be dead. That is the real thing what we have to do. So that technology, it is easily accessible. There are 6 points of technology which has been derived by the technological study of terrorism. Number one, whatever the technology that you are having, same technology they are having, number one. Number two, the technology they need not develop, you have to develop by research. They need not develop, they are given by special intelligence agencies throughout the world, number two. Number three, there are a lot of people working for them, crooked people, avaricious people, disloyal people to us and loyal people to them. And also lot of talented people are enslaved by threatening or intimidation by some other, lot of people are serving them also, number three. And number four, they are also having contemporary and competitive technology. Whatever you buy, before you, they buy that. And competitive, if you buy one version, they buy the second advanced versions. So number five, they are having their research and development unit, more than what you have now. Number six, we are not so qualified, we are not so speedy. So the rapidity, the promptitude, the dynamism, the activism, the acceleration that is there in development of technology, withholding of technology in storage, transportation, execution, etc., their intelligence operation, their executive operation is more sophisticated than us. We are at least 2 decades behind than what the terrorists are having now in intelligence, in technology, also in the spirit. There are 3 things. One is spirit, second is intelligence, and third is technology. No doubt, we can be blasted twice and they can be blasted thrice. It is a continuous war going on. Still updation, upgradation. Bombay people, they lamented, the police people. They are coming with AK-47s. And we are being given the very conventional rifles which we have been using at our grandfather periods. How a person can chase a Mercedes-Benz in a bullock cart? How it is that? So there is a technology mismatch between the servers of the society as well as the destroyers of the society. That must be made only by a total dedication of the community for more funding, more research, more implementation, more integration of the society, considering it as a common goal. Everything is insecure. Just as he has told about climate change, food security is there, water crisis is going to expected in 2020, air pollution, global climate change, it has resulted in the very great global warming issue, innumerable insecurities are there. But now we are concentrating on this insecurity. Homogenetic, heterogenetic, and onto our omnigenetic infusions are there in life. Human beings killed by their own kind is known as homogenetic. A nation or a clan or a group of people killed by a different group is heterogenetic. People totally killed by a common force like nature, it is known as omnigenetic. Now we are concentrating only on heterogenetic. We being totally dismantled by all the other people who are all enemies for our language, our culture, or for our religion, who are supported by local people. What is the network of terrorism? Number one, supporters. Number two, negligent people, those who don't bother about at all. Negligent people. Number three, reactors, those who are doing. Number four, sponsors. Number fifth, aiding agencies. Number sixth, their rulers or their community heads or institution heads. This is the hierarchy. And these negligent people, they are more. How many terrorists are there? When people invaded here, Mughals invaded, just 20,000 people, they were capable of capturing here 6 lakhs group of community and they could rule for few centuries. So this is due to only the weakness of the lack of integrity of the people, not to the greatness of their integrity. So our weakness is their strength. Their strength is not our weakness. They are not strong, but we are weak. And our weakness contributes strength to them. So let us instill by education and by means of knowledge dissemination through conferences, syllabi, and personal approach to rural and other areas, educate them how to be really brave, practically brave, instill in them the values of patriotism, and create a very powerful immunity against immorality, which is going to contribute the real national security. I wish that we must start from today dreaming the same thing, bring reality, which is the real reality in the global consciousness. Narayan, Narayan.